One of my viewers may have legitimately found a previously undiscovered impact crater within the vast desert of Saudi Arabia. The name of this viewer is Abdulrahman Toonsi, who you might remember from a video published 2 years ago where he also found clear-cut evidence of another undiscovered impact crater. That prior impact crater he called Toonsi Crater, which was located approximately 210 kilometers south-southeast of the city of Medina and measured 15 kilometers wide. Upon exploring the region in person, he found plenty of evidence that this circular feature carved into the boundary of two volcanic fields was caused by an asteroid impact due to the discovery of suevite and shocked quartz there. Well, since his initial discovery, he has decided to seek out and analyze in a lab samples from other suspiciously circular-looking features to determine if they have a similar origin. In the 2 years since, he has analyzed more than 30 separate locations without having any luck, as the vast majority of circular features were related to volcanism, dome anticlines, were just pure coincidence or marked salt domes. That was until he decided to analyze another circular feature that happened to be situated between two already known, albeit buried, impact craters approximately 67 kilometers southwest of the town of Migoa. Zooming in, we can already see several layers of suspiciously circular rock formations. After performing on-the-ground fieldwork within the structure and collecting various evidence, he determined that this was indeed an impact crater, which he named Hawi Crater after the name of a nearby seasonal lake and mining area to the south. Here is a quick series of photos from the interior of this largely buried and highly eroded impact crater. Hawi Crater measures either 3.5 or 6.5 kilometers wide based on the current interpretation, appears to be a complex impact structure with a central peak region of exposed younger rock units and likely formed between 10 and 30 million years ago. The reason A. Toonsi suggests two possible figures for this structure's diameter is that while there are currently exposed rock units in a 3.5 kilometer wide region that are presumably impact in origin, he also found scattered portions of a likely secondary ring containing Monomict Breccia in a circular region 6.5 kilometers wide. For reference, Monomict Breccia describes a rock type with abundant angular fragments that all originated from the same source rock. In this case, it is used to describe a type of rock instantly created when a large impactor strikes bedrock. During fieldwork, scattered fragments of suevite were also found. Suevite is also a type of breccia, but it contains glassy fragments of rock generated by the heat released by an impacting asteroid or comet. One telltale sign of suevite is blocks of material that are finely grained like glass that have a black or dark gray color interwoven with other rock fragments. These samples from the crater have this and thus are likely suevite. Toonsi also found an abundance of a clear-cut piece of evidence proving an asteroid or comet impact once occurred here. In a quartz vein found in a highly brecciated rock, he found numerous grains of what appeared to be shocked quartz, hence the planar deformation features or lines in this piece. And this is not a one-off feature either, as numerous other quartz grains in the vicinity contain the same thing. For comparison, here is a regular piece of quartz under a microscope. Shock quartz is incredibly rare in nature and only two things are able to create it, nuclear weapons tests, which have never occurred in Saudi Arabia, or extraterrestrial rock impacts, aka asteroids or comets. Intense pressure is needed to form shock quartz, which deforms some of the silicon dioxide into two polymorphs. Polymorphs are different minerals which have the same chemical formula but a different crystal structure such as calcite and aragonite. While not as spectacular or pristine as the much smaller Kamil Crater in Egypt or Amguid Crater in Algeria, Hawi Crater is still a scientifically interesting feature that reminds us of the violent past our planet has experienced. There are probably a fair number of other buried impact craters in various Middle East countries that have not yet been discovered since the main economic driver of most regional geologic projects are oil and natural gas discovery and extraction. Also, I want to note that A. Toonsi took all of the non-Google Earth still images in today's video, which are not specifically given attribution text. As a final note, I would like to thank my new patron, John Rumble, for supporting this channel.